Real quick Tokyo tour for you. This one's dedicated to all the project managers out there using ServiceNow to track your projects. This is the new project workspace. I say new in the general sense, it actually came out in the San Diego version, but Tokyo made some significant refinements to it, so I'm going to go over the whole interface. The first thing you'll notice is it's a significant aesthetic upgrade. Everything just a lot more clean and readable. One thing I love is this color coding. So in this planning phase, it's all green. And in this executing phase, it's all orange. The other thing that I love is it is way easier to add and reorganize fields on this field list here. So if I go to my settings, I'm gonna take the time constraint field and I'm gonna move it up towards short description. And now I see my time constraint is right beside short description where I said it should be. Other things you can do from the settings on the general tab is to display the summary task, which shows the whole project on the timeline, as well as show dependency lines, the critical path, and the new bar labels. I'm going to check the bar labels. And I love this because sometimes your short description just isn't visible. Sometimes you're looking more closely at the timeline than you are the fields. And why not know exactly what this bar represents? In the Advanced tab in Settings, you can turn auto-saving for this project on and off. And you can switch your date format from date to date time or vice versa. If I move this back to date and apply, my plan start and plan end are now displaying as dates instead of date times. So what's new in Tokyo? The first thing that I love is that you can take actions on multiple tasks at once. Somehow I've got my closeout phase, but my project closure, send closure, and NPS survey tasks should be underneath that, but aren't. So let me just grab all three of those and let me indent the tasks. So they are now contained within the project closeout. And as you can see, the tasks have moved under it on the work breakdown structure. Another thing they've added is a warning if your planned start date changes. So I've got this preliminary work task and I'm actually gonna put it prior to the planned start date of the whole project. So it's 9:05 right now. We're gonna change that to 9:01. And this warning box comes up to tell us that we are actually gonna change the start date of the project if we proceed with this. I'm gonna say yes, go ahead. And now we see it's moved to an earlier date and the entire project now starts on 9:01. Another feature brings us to parity with the old interface because now we can add external dependencies. So I'm gonna click this box here on the closeout, and before I can close this out, I need to be able to close another project out. So we're going to add an external dependency. We're going to make this dependent on the closure of the LMN project, and specifically the task in that is the closeout task, and it's going to be a hard dependency, so let's submit. Now our interface is showing where this dependency comes in. So we have line 6 is the deploy LMN project. I can actually view the project if I want to, but it's basically taking that external dependency and saying this phase depends on it. If we went back to the project it's dependent on and changed its timeline, this timeline would change as well. The final thing that Tokyo adds to the project workspace is a better financials interface. This is the San Diego interface, and I want you to remember what this part and this part look like. Now we're gonna go over to a Tokyo interface, and we'll see that we have some new tabs on our financial summary. The first is an overview, which is a different perspective of looking at your costs and actualizations and budget. This one breaks it down by fiscal period instead of cost types. And you can see that for fiscal year 16, your planned cost, your actual cost, and your budget, along with breakdowns for the CapEx, OpEx, and total. Really handy for those giant projects that span multiple fiscal periods where you gotta keep eyeballs on your plans and actuals. You'll also notice you have a funds tab. I am not using funds in my demo instance, but if you're using funds in your system, there's now access to that information as well. You'll also notice along the bottom, there's just a really quick and easy totals. So if you're on this overview tab, it's really easy to get to the totals of each of those columns just by looking at the bottom of the screen. So there you have it, folks. A little bit more control over our work breakdown structure by giving us the ability to move multiple project tasks at once, better warning systems for if our project start date is going to change, and a better interface for looking at our planned actuals and budgeted costs over the fiscal periods of the projects. I hope this was useful for you. If you enjoyed the way I explained this, I do consulting on the strategic portfolio management aspect of ServiceNow. My website will be in the description below. Reach out if you want some coaching on this.